Today, we begin to make our dream reality.
Hey, welcome everybody, One-Eyed Sniper here. Okay, so this is going to be the start of a Let's Play for Mass Effect Andromeda. I got the game a couple days early because I'm a member of the Origin Access, I think that's what it's called. So you get like, 5 days earlier, you get 10 hours of gameplay. So I think it came out yesterday for the Origin Access members. Okay, so I don't know, obviously this is going to be a blind Let's Play. I don't know much about Andromeda. Other than kind of some of the trailers I've seen, but basically I think we've traveled to a new galaxy and we're trying to colonize it. Or at least start up a colony in that area, and then obviously we run into some problems. Okay, so yeah, I've tweaked some of the settings to try to, like, the brightness and whatnot, so if you guys notice anything off, let me know. And I'll try to adjust for that. But we're gonna go ahead and jump in here. I'm gonna make a custom character. And what I'll do is I'll end up doing a flash forward here for while I'm customizing the characters. You don't have to sit through that. But then I'll kind of cover some of the choices I made class-wise, which I'm assuming we can do. So I've played through the other Mass Effects. I'm really happy to be back in the Mass Effect universe, even if it is a distant one. So I'm really interested to see how they do the, like, whole new storyline, because I'm sure they're going to reference some stuff to do with the original Mass Effect storyline. But they kind of have to be selective in what they do, because obviously we all made different choices, so I don't know. It'll be interesting to see what they do. I don't think they'll probably mention it sparingly, but I'm sure they'll do it occasionally. Okay, yeah, so I'll do a flash forward right here as I customize the character, and I will see you guys in a bit. Okay, welcome back, guys. All right, so I went ahead and I didn't do much customization, but came up with the guy. So for our training, we're going to go with a biotic. So we were effectively designated biotic during our Alliance military tenure, assisting your cohorts with your ability to control Mass Effect fields, and we get to start out with Throw, which I previously was one of the cooler powers, I thought. So we went with that. The name doesn't really matter. Our name's going to be Ryder. There's this. I don't know what this is. This is about the twin. It didn't take the one I picked. There we go. But yeah, I just picked one of the other non-default, or one of the ones that didn't start out with default. So I'm not sure what the whole twin thing's about, but there's that. And then you get to pick whether your Commander Shepard was a male or female. That was the only thing it let you choose for history. So I went with, when I played it, it was through a male character. So that's pretty much it. So let's just jump right into the game here. And, my name, yeah, I said it was Davith. That's one I always choose, but, like I said, I don't think you're ever going to hear the first name or see the first name anywhere. But, alright, let's jump right into it. Okay, let's see. Yeah, I'll go. You know, I'm just going to go normal this time. You guys don't need to see me dying a bunch. So I got this game on a solid-state drive, so we'll see how my loading time is.
Every great moment in our history began with a dream. Each bold leap forward was achieved by those willing to do anything to attain it. We are, all of us, leaving behind families, homes, the very birthplace of our species. Some for discovery, to see the unknown. Others for a new start. But today, whatever our reasons, we take the first steps toward a new future for humanity. Today, we begin to make our dream reality.
In the year 2185, humanity lives in a golden era of interstellar travel. Our discovery of ancient alien ruins on Mars propelled our understanding of science and technology ahead by thousands of years. While many now enjoy the newfound freedom and challenges of exploration in the Milky Way, others look to even more distant stars. For the 100,000 adventurers embarking on this one-way voyage, the future begins in Andromeda. I wonder if that's 634 years since the story of the original Mass Effect. They'll probably explain later, I'm assuming.
Deep breaths. You're gonna want to take it easy.
I've been taking it easy for 600 years.
Ryder, Recon Specialist, Pathfinder Mission Team.
Pathfinder Team, eh? The ones finding us a home.
Can you make it somewhere tropical? Nice, warm ocean? Summer year-round?
How about we get him a cup of coffee first?
Process saw the Andromeda Initiative evaluate thousands of potential habitable planets within the galaxy.
Ryder, let's get you checked out. Look here.
After discovering an unusually high ratio of potential candidates, or golden worlds, the Helios cluster was selected as our destination. Now you are a part of the first wave of ARCs arriving in Andromeda. Our new home for humanity.
Makes it sound so easy, doesn't it?
A tone choice helped define Ryder's personality. Okay, I guess I'll be a little bit flippant. Oh, I have to recognize the shapes. So that one's for casual, professional, okay.
I hope not. I signed up for a little adventure before we settled down.
Well, buckle up. Sounds like you'll get your wish.
Yeah.
Over here now, the Pathfinder wants you all on your feet right away. He said mission ready within the hour.
Any idea why?
No, but I'm guessing that's where your adventure comes in. Okay, everything checks out. Just one more thing before I send you on your way. Let's test your SAM implant. Sam, are you monitoring? Sam, are you online?
Yes, Dr. Tapero. Good morning, Ryder. Are you feeling well?
Okay, so I don't know. This looks like we got some kind of implant of... I don't know if it's going to be like an AI or what.
I just need a second to get my bearings. What's this about my implant?
A routine check. After being in stasis, we want to make sure the connection's still live.
As the team's mission computer, your well-being is my primary concern.
Assuming the implants work as advertised... Sam sees what you see, in theory. We won't know for sure until we get you in the field. How are you feeling, otherwise?
Okay, so I'm guessing it's just a link between the ship's computer and each individual.
I'm ready to get to it.
Readings confirmed. I detect an increased level of adrenaline in your system. The neural implant is functioning properly.
Caffeine always did make me jumpy.
You're all done. Let's get you on your way. Though you may want to hang around while we revive your sister. It always helps to see a familiar face.
I don't like the sound of that.
Oh, so it's literally our twin sister.
What's happening?
It broke free!
Just hang on!
Engineering, report!
Alright, so there's a big, some kind of growth in space.
This is Cora. I'm at the cryo bay. Brace for a reset. Everyone okay?
I think so.
What happened?
We're not sure. Sensors are scrambled. But it's good to see you're up. Feels like centuries since we spoke.
This is the Pathfinder. Mission teams continue preparations. Cora, Riders, report to the bridge.
You heard him. Let's get...
We have a problem over here. It's Sarah Ryder.
What's wrong?
I don't know. Have to check it out.
Well?
Okay, so that's... Alright, let's see.
Some sort of power surge hit the stasis pod. Are they okay? I'm running a diagnostic now.
Ryder?
Is my sister okay?
Sarah's fine. Her vitals are strong. But the revival procedure was interrupted.
When can she wake up?
We don't want to rush it. Sam?
My connection to Sarah's implant was suspended. However, her pulse, respiration, and brain activity are all normal.
To be on the safe side, we'll need to keep her in a low-level coma for a while, then let her body regain consciousness naturally. She'll be fine.
Glad to hear it.
Thanks, Lexi. Keep us updated. Ryder, I'll wait for you at the door, whenever you're ready to go.
Okay, so that's kind of cool how they did that. So depending on which character you chose is which one actually wakes up. You chose the male or female. Let's keep talking to Dr. Pyro.
Right.
Or not. Okay. So I remember I read a couple reviews and they were talking about how some of the facial expressions and mannerisms of the people was a little odd. That's something I probably wouldn't have noticed on my own, but now that I've read it, I think I probably will. I've already seen some that I thought looked a little weird during that crash.
Hi there. I'm Gian Garson, founder of the Andromeda Initiative. I'm here to welcome you to a whole new galaxy. The good news is, the hard part's over. We're here. If you have any questions now, just ask.
Okay, cool. It's like an interactive wall.
At present, Ark Hyperion has arrived in the Helios Cluster. Further mission updates are offline due to technical difficulties. As recon specialist, you are tasked with supporting the authentication of Golden World sites through exploration, mapping, and scientific analysis. Currently, you are to report for duty on the command bridge.
Damage control team to propose.
It's kind of handy.
The Andromeda Initiative encompasses all colonization efforts, including Arks, Pathfinders, Outposts, and the Central Support Hub, the Nexus. The current location of the Nexus is unknown. Status of outposts are unknown.
I'm Gian Garson, founder of the Initiative. I think it's important we take a moment to reflect on the principles that brought all of us together. It started with a vision of a better future. A vision that you shape. Life in Andromeda can be anything we dare to dream. And I'm proud to help make those dreams come true. Drop me a note sometime. I'd love to hear how we're doing.
Yeah, I'm sure she would. You know, you think if they took the time to record the audio, they would just do video. But, yeah, whatever. Looks like the Andromeda Initiative is cutting some costs.
Your current location is Ark Hyperion, housing the human population. Ark Parchero, the Solarian vessel, confirmed departure in 2185. The Asari ship, Ark Lucinia, confirmed departure that same year, as did the Turian Ark Natanis, embarking in 2185.
It's interesting. Okay. So, is this a human Ark, which has some aliens on board, obviously, and then all the other major races as well.
The selection process saw the Andromeda Initiative evaluate thousands of potential habitable planets within the galaxy. After discovering an unusually high ratio of potential candidates, or Golden Worlds, the Helios Cluster was selected as our destination. Now you are a part of the first wave of Arks arriving in Andromeda, our new home for humanity. Once the Pathfinder team's assessment is complete, Habitat 7 has been selected as the most likely candidate for colonization.
So one thing I'm curious about is if the Andromeda thing, obviously there's a bunch of different races traveling. Is it some kind of, I wonder if it's like a race to get there first? Is there any kind of competition between them, or is it just trying to spread all life across the galaxy?
The Pathfinder is responsible for exploring and assessing new worlds for outpost placement and settlement. Each Ark is led by a Pathfinder who represents their species. The active duty Pathfinder assigned to Ark Hyperion is Alec Ryder. Current duty roster shows you are assigned to the Pathfinder Mission Team, Specialist Ryder.
Okay, my name isn't Alec, and I think it was Scott if you went with the default name, so I'm not sure what the Alec thing's about. Maybe we'll find out. Okay.
It sounds amazing, doesn't it? Right up until you lose gravity.
So this is supposed to be more of an open world adventure as well, so hopefully they do better than they did in 1. But don't have anything like mindless scanning like they did in 2. We'll see how they did though. I'm also interested in see what combat's like, how it's kind of evolved from the other games. 1 seemed the most like RPG-ish to me, and then they slowly got more action after that. But then 1 had a lot of issues as well. Okay, let's go find out what's going on here. We'll go talk to the I guess mission commander, whatever his name was. Message from Captain Dunn. Attention Hyperion personnel, after a 600-year voyage, the good news is we're exactly where we're supposed to be. We have arrived in the Helios Cluster, Andromeda Galaxy, year 2819. All Stasis medical personnel should report for duty immediately. Give the Pathfinder mission team revival priority and prep its members for field reconnaissance. Reports of an unusual celestial phenomenon in the cluster are being investigated. Updates to follow, Captain Dunn.
Still dreaming.
You left a nasty bump on your head. Let me take a look.
First 5 minutes in Andromeda, and we're already crashing the car.
True that.
No, but I figured any scars could wait till we land.
Gravity loss means something tripped the generators.
Like what?
Something big. Those generators are hardened. It'd take a hell of a lot to overload them.
On the bright side, nobody's.
So the whole talking to people thing isn't always. It shows up, but it doesn't always trigger anything. Interesting.
What's wrong?
Got a surge in power readings.
Well, that's not gonna be good. Yes. Investigate the malfunction. Alright, we'll be there in a second. Oh, hold on, let me see how that works. It just directs
Ryder
the camera to it.
He has a scanner. Quick, Ryder, use it to locate the vault.
On it.
I'll try to get readings on the second conduit.
Hey,
I'll try
to get on this one. I'll override the safeties.
Got it. Hurry, Ryder, try to...
There's no indication of a fault in this component.
Keep looking.
Power surge is getting worse.
Relay 2C shows damage from a temperature spike.
Found it! Bad relay. Ryder, can you go reset it?
Sure. Oh, that scanner thing's kinda cool.
There! It's reset!
Do it. We're routing the turret now.
Oh, let's get away from that.
It's working!
Readings are in the green.
Thank God. That could have been the end of everyone in the cryo bay.
Well, good thing you had a random dude with a scanner handy.
Good job, Ryder. Now we can get to the tram.
was close.
You okay?
Barely in Andromeda, and we're already scrambling.
The adventure begins.
All right, lead the way, Cora.
I'm sure your dad will see it that way.
Okay, well, that explains the Alec thing. Got it.
Go ahead and take us to the bridge.
Yeah, I'll do that for you.
Helm control, report.
We're drifting.
Flight controls aren't responding.
First priority is stopping these outages.
Mainline power's been knocked out. We're on reserves, Captain. They won't last.
The hell is that?
What's our position?
Unknown. We lost telemetry.
Sam, we need eyes out there.
Attempting to adjust sensor array.
Alec, please. You may be Pathfinder, but this is my ship.
Captain, the protocol's clear. In the absence of communication with the Nexus or the other arcs, we proceed to our appointed golden world. Solid ground.
If it's even out there. Nobody said anything about running into an energy cloud. And that's just a wild guess what we hit.
It's like a
Alec, I need to assess
space reef.
Stop the bleeding. We've got 20,000 people asleep on this ship. Let's give them a chance to wake up.
Can you blame her?
She is the captain. I think she gets the final word.
Well, he might.
This isn't about having the final word.
Yes, sir.
We're coming through.
Well, nice dirty look, Dad. Thanks.
My God. Is that our golden world?
That's Habitat 7. New Earth, if we're lucky. All of our long-range scans told us it was in the green zone. Perfect for human settlement.
It doesn't even look the same.
Logical. Yeah, we'll go emotional here. Or what is it? Yeah, emotional.
We don't know how bad it is yet. Still seems like it's our best shot.
Maybe. There's just a lot on the line.
Sam?
The energy from the phenomenon is damping our senses. Planetary conditions are unknown.
We're marooned. 20,000 souls adrift at sea. And when the power runs out and stays out, we need to know if that's safe harbor.
And if it's not?
As Pathfinder, it'll be my job to find an alternative. It's what we trained for. But if this goes well, we're already home.
All right, just make it quick.
Harper, the rest of the team should be awake by now. Have them spin up two shuttles. Planet Fallen 30.
Yes, sir.
I have a bad feeling about Alec's chances on this mission.
A stubborn one, isn't he?
He cares in his own way. Enough to give him a chance.
I suppose you're right. He is our Pathfinder. If this doesn't work out, we'll need him more than ever.
I need an ETA on our sensor repairs. We're blind out here.
Okay, so we're just on the Pathfinder team. We're not the actual Pathfinder. That would be our father.
My sister's gonna hate that she missed this.
Are all the riders adrenaline junkies?
I guess it's in her blood. She beat me into the world by 1 minute. Couldn't wait to get started.
Well, don't worry. I'm sure Sarah will pull through.
When she does, she's gonna want stories.
So, let's get out there and find her some.
Harper and Ryder, to the hangar.
Right. You'll want to get your helmet. And maybe stop at the Good Luck Rock before we go.
The what?
It's an old superstition of your dad's.
Good luck, Rock. All right, let's go rifling through other people's lockers real quick.
Looks like Dad's already suited up. Hang in there, Sarah.
So we just open the locker and think about him. That's a little bit messed up. If First contact protocol. In the event any member of the Pathfinder team encounters intelligent alien life, it is imperative that first contact protocols be strictly observed. The Andromeda Initiative holds the principles of peace and cooperation among our highest ideals. Aggressive action against extraterrestrials is only permitted when hostile intent is clearly demonstrated and Pathfinder team members are at obvious risk of injury or death. Alright, roger that. Try to keep that in mind.
Got it.
That should do it.
The Pathfinder is now requiring sidearms. I've opened the armaments locker.
We expecting trouble, Sam?
A precaution. Please arm yourself, Ryder.
Crashing the party, huh?
Sorry.
Hey, what?
Oh, I turned off their music. Okay. They got a scan indicator, I think. Dad's rock.
Analysis indicates alkali feldspar and quartz, commonly known as granite.
Alright, I'm sure there's some story behind why that's good luck rock.
Hey, Fisher, how's it going?
I heard a rumor from the bridge that your dad and the captain aren't seeing eye to eye on this.
Please report in as soon as possible.
I don't know, it didn't seem that bad. But, we'll be honest with them, we're just a couple normal dudes.
She wasn't thrilled with the idea of the expedition, but my dad won her over.
I heard you weren't a big fan of it either.
It's her ship, her call.
You got guts going against the old man. The way I see it, Pathfinder team answers to the Pathfinder. Besides, your dad's the N7 here. He's got the best aim. I go wherever he goes.
Alright, good point. I guess we are working directly for him, so... Okay, Pathfinder team field manual introduction. As a member of the Pathfinder team, you play a critical role in the Andromeda Initiative's effort to establish a foothold in the new galaxy. The team faces many challenges. Golden World site verification, reconnaissance and mapping of unknown territories, planetary and celestial, scientific analysis and discovery of new phenomenon, potential first contact with extraterrestrials, establishing diplomatic relations with local inhabitants, general support of settlement outpost. Okay, now one of the things we're going to have to do is set up outposts as we go along in the game. Alright, let's see what we got. I don't know what... It didn't tell me what weapons the different classes got, so... I don't know if it's going to be like one, where you have access to all weapons, but specialize in some... I don't know. We'll see how that is.
Hope I won't need this.
Okay, right now we just got the pistol. I don't know if it would have been different if I was a different class, but...
Careful with that, Ryder.
Gotcha. Alright. So our menu, let's holster it. Keep moving here.
Better not. No bathroom breaks on this trip.
Really? Your suit doesn't take care of that? It's interesting.
Oh, so just another boring day at the office, huh?
If it was, this wouldn't be any fun. I can't wait to find out what's down there.
I know what you mean. I always wondered what it was like when explorers crossed the ocean. Nothing but stars and dead reckoning to guide them.
And a map that said, here be dragons.
Well, if they made it, we can too. And maybe see a dragon along the way.
Yeah, let's not get eaten.
I prefer to eat lunch, not be lunch.
You're not a real explorer till you've got some scars or bite marks.
On that note, time to get to the shuttle.
Alright, let's do this.
Dr. Carlyle, with everything going on, I think the Ark needs you more than we do.
Pathfinder wants a medic on hand, and if that is home down there, I'm happy to knock on the door.
If it's what we hope it is, it'll be one for the history books. You got a quote ready? One small step?
I'm pretty sure your dad will handle that honor.
All right, team, button it
up. I got a bad feeling about dad's.
Sir, we broke out the weapons
as requested.
Anything we should know about?
Seem prudent given the situation.
We'll be short-handed with Sarah out. I heard what happened. Your sister's strong. She'll make it.
We bet on whose boots would hit the ground first. This isn't how I wanted to win.
Well, knowing Sarah, she'll want to go double or nothing on who climbs the tallest mountain. Don't let it get you down. I need you sharp.
I understand.
Your mom would have been proud of both of you. Okay, team, listen up. I chose each of you for the Pathfinder team, not just because you're talented and passionate, but because you're dreamers, like me. We dream of exploring the unknown, of finding the edge of the map, and then discovering what lies beyond. When people look back on this, and they will, they'll remember we didn't give up, that we kept dreaming. That our first few faltering steps in Andromeda were the beginning of everything they know. We only get one chance to be first. So, let's go make history.
Been waiting 600 years for this.
He gets an assault rifle. We got one on the team.
Archive period, this is Shuttle 1. Switching to manual guidance.
Shuttle 2, taking your lead.
Good luck, Pathfinder team.
Turning to Vector 135.
Copy that. We're on point.
Wow, will you look at that? Whatever it is, it stopped the Hyperion in its tracks.
It appears to be an unstable mass of dark energy.
Say so.
It seemed pretty solid. But I don't really know what dark energy is, so I guess maybe it is solid.
Gravity anomalies detected.
Whoa, it's gone.
We're clear. Accelerating to cruising speed.
Ryder, we didn't have a chance to meet back in the Milky Way. Name's Liam Costa, security and response specialist.
Good to meet you, Liam.
Hard to believe we're finally doing this.
Sure beats reading the brochures.
Beginning our deceleration. Planet's dead ahead. Hang on. Initiating atmospheric entry.
Here we go.
The flight guidance is scrambled. It'll pass.
We're in the line.
The controls are fighting me. We're through.
Holy.
Shuttle 2, are you seeing this?
Copy that. Doesn't look like a golden world from here.
Looks like this planet sucks.
Stay on course to the landing zone.
Oxygen levels are below minimum human requirements.
Is this the right planet? We had this all worked out.
Keep it tight, Shuttle 2.
The mountains are floating.
Look, port side!
That has to be advanced engineering.
Hyperion, this is the Pathfinder. We've got evidence of an alien civilization.
Has anyone seen us?
What if they're not friendly?
We stick to contact protocol. No use of deadly force unless hostile intent is clear.
Holy
shit!
Acceleration increasing.
Oh, this isn't good.
Your jump jet is malfunctioning.
Get it working!
Approaching terminal velocity.
Sam!
Well, that's some handy technology right there. So 620 years isn't that long in planetary time frame. So something Something sudden and severe had to happen here. Because apparently there's vacuum here, so it's not even oxygen. Intrigued by these plants here.
Ryder, how's your survival training?
I've seen my share of troubles. Nothing crazy, but...
Well, crazy just found us. Those rocks out there are floating.
Terra incognita.
Alright, so I'm gonna guess that it wasn't like...
Some of these plants look like tentacles. Is the water here even water?
I'm gonna guess it wasn't lightning that actually knocked out the, shuttle, because we seem to handle re-entry really well, so I'd imagine that lightning wouldn't be enough to just take one out. But
we saw on the way in. Who could survive in a place like this?
Oh, he's talkative. Okay, let's check a look at what we've got in our menu now. Journal Planet Side. The scouting mission on Habitat 7 is met with disaster. The planet is far from the golden world the initial scans indicated. Instead, its atmosphere is toxic and racked with deadly electrical storms that struck the shuttle. Survive the hostile conditions and locate any survivors from the rest of the Pathfinder team. Alright, so now we're just looking for survivals. We've also got a codex, which we'll go through at some other point. Let's see, what about skills? Let's see, what does Liam got going on? He's got frag grenade. Standard issue grenade, okay. He's going to have end up having havoc strike. Liam leaps forward and stabs down enemies with his omni-blades, discharging their power to stun all nearby enemies. Prime them for combo detonation. Okay. Overload needs to be unlocked. Gotcha. Okay. So what do we got going on? Combat. Okay, we can also do an Omni Grenade. Okay, so that's right. There's no, like, set classes in this. I forgot about that. So it looks like you can pretty much level however you want. You just pick a starting class that gives you some starting skills, I think. So we don't have any skills in anything, like pistol-wise. So we've still got the standard weapons, pistol, assault rifle, shotgun, sniper rifle. Are these all the skills? Okay, so these are all the combat skills, at least so far. Biotics, so we've got one in throw, pulls here, charge. Launching the user, okay. Trying to see if there's anything new. Nova looks new. Channels energy into a point-blank, high-damage explosion around the user. Cool. Shockwave's not new. Annihilation. Okay, we'll look at these as we're going to go once we start leveling up. And then what else we got? This is more like engineer-based stuff. Alright, that's cool. So I'm glad I'm not, like, limited to any kind of weapon restrictions right off the bat. I think all we have on us now is a pistol, though, so... doesn't look like there's anywhere to equip gear. Oh wait, hold on. It's just not open yet. I'm also really interested to see how they did that, because the equipment screen in Mass Effect 1 was trash, but then to me there wasn't a whole lot to do in 2. So we'll see how they've decided to go with that. Alright, let's do a little bit of exploring here. Alright, the visuals are badass. I'm all on board here.
Storms here don't seem natural.
Got scanning indicator.
Damaged in the crash. No good to us now.
So that's okay, that's just part of our shuttle. Irrelevant data.
We should get on with it.
Alright. Okay, scanning unknown technology and life forms earns you research data points. Then research data at research center to unlock new weapons and armor. Okay, what were we scanning now? Now, okay, Sam's currently on offline, so we can't really tell us much.
No fixing this. Must have broken on impact.
Explains why we lost our sound connection.
I'm gonna see if I can scan this plant, because I'm curious.
Well, without Sam, it's hard to say exactly what this is.
Okay,
sort of a plant, and maybe dead, but maybe not.
67% probability of, of plant life. Photosynthetically inefficient, possibly carnivorous. Alright, well, we want to stay away from those then. Because if it's carnivorous, it's going to be in a terrible way, I'm sure. Not just catching flies.
Oh, and safety tip. Don't breathe the air. Found that out the hard way.
Got it.
Multicellular fungal life form, bioluminescence enzyme detected, high variance in cellular mutation detected. Okay. I wonder if this planet's being terraformed for some other life form. If that's kind of what's happening here. That would kind of explain why there'd be such a drastic shift. Unless we were lied to about what this planet was supposed to be like. Okay, well there's some kind of atmosphere here that can... let fire happen. But I guess that could be a number of things. It doesn't have to be oxygen.
You think that energy cloud we saw could cause all this?
Sam said it's dark energy, but that's in space.
Yeah, hell of a cloud.
A cloud that makes boulders float.
Okay, I hear gunfire. Oh, maybe it's lightning.
What the hell is this? Come on, we gotta get through it.
This is crazy!
Welcome to Habitat 7! Keep moving!
Alright, go, don't get struck by lightning. Watch out, Liam.
Damn it! Shit, that hurt!
Look safer under there!
Whoa, whoa. Okay, I got access to the jetpacks already. Interesting, okay.
Planet's trying to murder us?
It can try.
Right now I can just jump with it.
How's your guys? Might want to see if it's working. Take a shot at that fuel cell. It's busted anyway.
Test your weapon on a damaged fuel cell.
Look, something flying around in the sky.
Oh, wow.
Here be dragons. Korra will love it.
Yeah. Sure, if we're gonna test our weapon, why not shoot something that'll explode?
I'd say it's working.
Okay, so we're back to a magazine, but I've... One of the things I read, looks like you can mod your weapons to maybe go back to the old style of, just overheating.
There! We get up that cliff, we find high ground. Come on!
Not sure we want to be the tallest thing around here.
Do I just approach it, or do I have to, like, do something with it? Okay, I don't think that was the ammo box. That's probably that over there. Gotcha. But I'm not gonna shoot the terrible looking creature right now. Let me scan this. Was that something? Nope. Okay. So B does like a little forward dash. Okay, so that refilled our ammo. Okay.
I think I can see a path up. We'll use the jump jets if we have to.
Into the breach!
Think I'd rather fall than get hit by lightning.
Give it a minute. We can probably do both.
Right, hold on, Liam.
More glowing mushrooms.
Are they making that noise?
No. Coming from inside the mountain. Detecting a lot of energy. Can't make heads or tails of it, but it's powerful.
Geological fault, danger, high energy levels detected. Ah, nice. There's something in the bones of this planet going wrong here.
How'd my dad find you?
I was a cop. In crisis response.
Yeah?
Tell you over a beer sometime.
Whoa. There's a little bit of platforming involved. So that means I'm gonna screw up occasionally. That wasn't that bad.
That's it. We're getting there.
Doesn't look like he has like a... Oh yeah, he does. Okay. Just was less dramatic when he used it. I missed that note. Oh. But I guess I did it right. Hold A as you jump to a ledge to grab on. Yeah, we already learned that.
Mind making some room? Thanks. What the hell is that? Not a hotel, that's for sure. Nothing around here makes any sense. New galaxy, new ways to die. Just not today.
Ryder, it's Fisher.
Wait. Look.
Okay, new alien. Yeah, I'm not an idiot. We're gonna... They look hostile to me.
Just be ready if this goes south. It usually does. Just say the word and I go hot. They haven't spotted us yet.
Well, I'm not gonna just shoot them, I guess. But yeah, we're gonna...
Nyan, shoot it!
He sees us!
We can't understand you! Give us our man, or this gets ugly!
What's the other guy? Shit, they're beating him.
Alright, that's not gonna happen. Well, that's not what I want to do. There we go. Gotcha. Yeah, it's true. Can't just beat people.
Only thing I know for sure, their guns hit just as hard as ours. the others?
Gone. Kirkland and Greer went looking for help.
Come on.
Ah, my leg!
Can you move?
I think it's broken. You guys push ahead and look for the others.
You sure?
Yeah. Just find us a ride out of here. And take a few more of them out while you're at it.
Help, I'm just...
Take a look at these bodies. What are these things?
Okay, the icon highlights optional objectives with additional information or rewards. Okay. That's so we're gonna scan these guys.
Well, I don't have Sam here, but I can try to make sense of it. They're DNA-based, and their armor reads as some kind of bone. But the genetics are all over the map.
Ah. I guess life took a different turn here, huh?
Yeah, they look kind of rock-based to me. Mineral-based, I guess.
Okay. We'll find them.
What about this guy?
His friend here is the same.
Okay. Alright guys, we are gonna go ahead and end this episode here. We'll explore the crash site and continue on to find, hopefully find our father and the rest of the team in the next one. We are gonna have to find a new ride, because I think this is their shuttle. But this might be the front half of our shuttle, so maybe we still have a working shuttle. Yeah, this is probably the front half of our team. Alright, we're getting lightning strikes here as well. But, okay guys, thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed it. I'm enjoying it so far. Look, combat was smooth. I didn't detect any awful writing like I heard about. The facial stuff was a little weird. I guess that's gonna happen randomly. But yeah, nothing to turn me off from the game so far. I know I'm only 40 minutes in, but yeah, I'm really enjoying it. So hopefully you join me for the rest of this this quest so we can find out what's going on here. On this Andromeda mission. Alright, guys, like I said, thanks for watching. I know you have a choice of where you watch your Mass Effect Let's Plays, and I thank you for choosing One-Eyed Sniper. Peace out, everyone.